Welcome people. I'm really sorry that I haven't posted from a long while because I too was learning lessons from life. Moreover, what I wanted to share is that we take life for granted, and the truth is everything is temporary and everything is uncertain. Today I'm here, might not be tomorrow, and the same goes for you. So till we exist over here on this beautiful planet, let's not forget to give to others whatever little we may even have. Just like a lamp burns itself but lightens up the lives of so many. Similarly, we must learn how to love in this time when there's so much of hatred going on around. And art is the message of love for me. So I would just like to say that here I present to you a little bit of art I just wanted to share. And hope you like it. So let's begin. For this tutorial, firstly you'll be requiring a photo editing software called ColorGrab. You can download it from the Play Store or anywhere else. Then you need to first select a reference photo. This reference photo, the credit is given to CHLOESHEA. I think you can find a profile on Instagram. But I really like this picture which I found from Pinterest. So you can upload it, and then this software helps you to basically decide your color values. You can pick any color values from the skin of the required part of whatever subject you are using. And for me today the subject is going to be the beetle. So yeah, just see how it is so easy to pick up any colors abstract also from the skin of the beetle, from the shell of the beetle I'd rather say. So you can see how using precision you can zoom out, zoom in, and even pick different values and tones. Then you can calculate a color map which will tell you exactly what colors you'll require, and those you can make on your palette later with your color pencils. Or on any piece of paper you can make those tones using a lot of color pencils and mixing them. And don't worry, it's not as difficult as it looks. It is very simple. It's just that you need to have the hang of it. Next, what we'll require are materials. And don't worry, I'm not going to be providing you with links of very expensive stuff. I myself use a lot of cheap stuff. As you can see, these are Faber-Castell color pencils, and they work really fine for me. They are not as expensive. And using them, you could just take a piece of paper and start making the tones for the particular part of the beetle which you want to make. And it is not as difficult as I've said. It's just that you need some practice. And if not practice, you just give in some time to make the tones. Everything will turn out really well. This was my first hyper-realistic piece, and even I wasn't as confident. But don't worry, if you put in some time and effort, everything will happen. Next up, as you can see, we have few sketch pens. These sketch pens are also not very expensive. You can use any sketch pen. And moreover, I would suggest you to blend the sketch pen. Not by your fingers. Over here, I just use that as a gesture. Not using your fingers, but rather using the base of the sketch pen itself. But make sure that you don't dirty your work. That will give the smoothness of texture. And in any hyper-realistic piece, I would suggest you to be very diverse with your materials. Because in my experience, different and diverse materials can make a piece look much more realistic. Next, we have the poster color. It's just a white paint. I used it to make the white spots on the beetle shell. I just had a sharp object. You can use anything, a needle, a pin, anything. I used my sculpture tool. And you can dip it in the paint and keep adding it over the color pencil marks or the sketch pen marks, and that will really work very well for you. Next, we have a pen. For pen, I used a variety of pens from blue ink to black ink. So basically these help me detail a lot. If you seen the reference photograph, there are many dark areas, so I used a pen for them. For pencils, again I used Faber-Castell pencils, and these are not so really expensive as well. They really worked well for me. Then you have normal sharpener and eraser that work well. So this was my final piece, and with this I intend to show you where I used what. So you just need to observe really well, and if you can observe well, most of the work in hyperrealism is done. It's just about observing. That's about hyperrealism. All observing. Then you can see the shadows and the textures over there. You might think that I think the shadow looks very natural over here. I didn't use any pencils, but rather what I did was, behind the pens there's a certain area with which if you drag it across the paper, it produces these sort of marks. So this will work really well for you. You can have any pen or any substance like that which produces these sort of marks, and you can create these marks. But just remember that once you create them, they cannot be erased. So that is what I would like to warn you about. After that, the white spots, as I said, I took my sculpture tool, the sharp object inside, I put it inside the paint, then again I used them. For different parts of the leg, where you can see the dark tones, I used a pen and I blended them a bit like how I taught you earlier. But don't use your finger much, because that could really spoil your work. And that's all with our materials. Very minimalistic in nature, very cheap in nature. You'll just need to learn how to observe and be patient, and you'll be able to do it. Moving on to the process itself, you'll have to draw outlines with a very light pencil. Be confident you can do it, and add a layer of white color pencil above everything. That will really add a reflection of realism over there. Then you slowly start working your way up, invest quality time. Only this much took me around 2 hours. But once you get the hang of just the head, you'll know the entire body. Trust me on it. I can guarantee that. Then slowly you build up more details, more better colors, and don't forget to add the white coating. This much took me around 3-4 hours. And once you do this, you'll realize the entire body. Work in parts. As you can see over here, there's a lot of white layer which I've added. And then slowly you work your way up, and you'll slowly see there'll be a lot of improvement coming, and you'll really enjoy the process. Don't forget to enjoy the process. Observe and you will learn. I could not emphasize this enough. So go ahead, observe how I'm doing it. Pick your own style. Don't try to copy me or somebody else. Work with your own style. All I can do is help you with basically the techniques, and make art into a prayer, into meditation. That is what will help you in life too. So I hope I could be of some help to you. Thanks a ton for watching this. Do like and subscribe. Signing out, Art in Existence.